Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. So a new feature of Keynote version 9 is the ability to export your presentations as animated GIFs. Let's take a look. MacMost is brought to you by the more than 300 people that support it through its Patreon campaign. Find out how you could become a part of it at MacMost.com/Patreon. So let's get one thing out of the way first. Is it GIF or GIF? Well, I think either one's acceptable. But as a guy named Gary, I gotta go with GIF. So Keynote 9 doesn't really add that much to Keynote, but one of the new features is the ability to export as an animated GIF. And this is useful if you want to upload something to, say, Facebook or a website or even send it as a text message. So here's one example, and this is a plain normal presentation with 5 slides that you would normally just show one after the other. There's no animation, there are no transitions, nothing. So the basic functionality is you go to File, Export To, and then the new feature is Animated GIF. So you have to choose which slide. So you need to fill in how many slides you want. So I want all 5 slides. Now I get to choose a resolution. You've got small, medium, large, extra large. Now notice at the bottom it'll tell you the duration and resolution. And here it says 480 by 270. So that's what it means by medium. If I go to large, 720 by 405, extra large, 1080 by 608. So go ahead and just pick medium for this example. Frame rate isn't going to matter that much for this presentation because every frame is just static. But it will matter when we look at animations later. And then auto advance is how quickly to go from one slide to the next. Since you can't interact with an animated GIF, you can't click it to advance to the next slide. So it's just going to do that automatically. So we'll go with a full 1 second here. So we're going to get something that's 5 seconds long for 5 frames. Makes sense. 480 by 270. We'll go next, and that'll allow us to choose our destination. We'll save it to the desktop. So here is my desktop. If I select it and press the space bar, it'll show it to me in Quick Look, which doesn't render animated GIFs very well. It seems to go just from the first one to the last one after a period of time. So we're not going to use that. We're going to use animated GIFs in its native environment, which is on a web page or web browser. So I'm just going to drag and drop it into Safari, and it loads in Safari, and you can see it advances through the slides automatically, gets to the end, and it loops. So let's look at what happens when you add transitions. So for this first slide, I'll go to Animate in the sidebar here, and I'll add an effect. So I'll have it go and do, let's say, a dissolve. So it'll dissolve from this to the next slide. On the next one, we'll go and we'll do something a little more interesting. We'll do a grid, and on this one we'll add a, let's say, fade and move. Now when we go to export, we'll select slide 1 to 4, and we'll choose medium again, 24 frames a second. So the frames per second really does matter here because it gives more frames for the animation. 24 is okay, 15 it might seem a little choppy, and 30 will seem really smooth. But of course it's going to add more file size. And we'll have it auto advance every 1 second. Go next, and then I'll export this to the desktop. So let's drag this one to Safari, and now it'll bring it in, and you can see it's doing each transition as part of the animation. The file size is going to be significantly more because of all of those frames of animation there. So it's one thing to keep in mind. Now there are all sorts of special effects you can use in Keynote, like you can make text appear in weird and interesting ways. And these will also export as part of the animated GIF. So here is a text box, and we're just going to have a build-in effect here. And we'll use something fun and interesting like the comet effect. Like that. And then when we export that to the animated GIF, and you can see it includes that effect there. And finally, let's look at some animation. You can animate on a path in Keynote. So here I have a shape that's just on a single slide by itself. I will add an action effect here, and I'll make it move. And when it does that, it shows me this red path here. So I'm going to bend that red path and move this around here. I'm going to option click on the path to create another point and move it around. So now I can preview it and I can see what it looks like. So as you can guess, of course, when you export to animate a GIF, that's all included. So the options here are pretty basic. You can't delay any more than 1 second, which would be useful if you're trying to show a presentation. And maybe you want to have each slide up there for 3 or 4 seconds so people can read the text. But you can also take a slide and under Animate, you can change the transition from on click to automatically and then change the time. So notice I'm going to make this a 10 second slide. And now when I go to Export, I'll say I want to go from 1 to 5 as before, 1 second auto advance. Notice duration is now 14 seconds. So 4 of those slides are going to auto advance and do it at 1 second. But the slide here that I set to 10 seconds, that will actually sit there for 10 seconds. So you can actually really set the timings for each slide specifically. But if you really want to play with the size, the dimensions of the GIF and maybe some other features and maybe get some more compression out of it, you're still probably better off using a specialized app to convert a video to a GIF. And then you export from Keynote as a video, then you import it into the specialized app. But this is a really good way for most uses, and it's really quick and easy to do to get an animated GIF to share online.